Welcome in France in Pont de Rouen near Tours for the sixth round of the French Rallycross Championship. As you can see, weather conditions aren't that fine. Part of the paddock was underwater, but the organizers quickly found a solution. But the track remained very slippery and very difficult. It's the first time that Pont de Rouen holds a round for the French Rallycross Championship, and everybody does his or her utmost best to make it an unforgettable event. Pity about the weather conditions then. We'll start off with a heat in Division 3 with one of the title contenders at the start, Marc Maurice, in the black Peugeot. Next to him, Florent Boudinot in the Mini Cooper, together with Guy Moreton in the Citroën. And it's Boudinot who takes the best start in his Mini. And even for these four-wheel drive cars, these conditions are very difficult. Sliding out of the corner, Boudinot takes the lead. Moreton goes for his choker lap. So now it's between Boudinot and Marc Maurice. Marc Maurice second in the championship behind Christophe Saunois and his Toyota. Boudinot third in the championship. Has finished on the podium in every round so far this year, but is still waiting for his first win. And there's a mistake for Boudinot. Went wide in the parabolica leading up to the straight. And Marc Maurice has taken the lead. That might be a costly mistake for Boudinot, who goes for his joker lap. Can he stay out in front of Moreton? That will be very close. No, the Citroën takes second position. A very expensive mistake then by Boudinot. But he still might set a good time overall, because these two drivers, Maurice and Moreton, go very quickly as well. But it's a pity, because Boudinot was leading this heat, and now the heat win will undoubtedly go to Marc Maurice. Going for his joker lap should be no problem if he makes no mistakes. The exit is wide enough, and Marc Maurice stays in front of Moreton, but it's closer than I thought it would be. So Maurice still leading from Moreton and Boudinot. Final corner, and it's a heat win for Maurice. Moreton even hits the guardrail, and Boudinot third in the heat and fourth overall still.
Bah, la deuxième manche était bien partie, j'ai fait un bon départ. Et puis je savais que la piste était piégeuse, et malgré tout, dans la grande parabole avant la ligne droite, j'ai fait une erreur qui m'a coûté assez cher, et Marc a passé. Et puis après, j'ai voulu me refaire un petit peu, mais bon, en voulant mettre de trop, on fait toujours des petites erreurs, et Moreton est passé, Guy Moreton est passé. Donc je finis 3, mais de la manche. Mais j'aurais pas pensé finir 4 au cumul quand même.
Boudinot surprised that he still finished in 4th overall, and admits that he made some small mistakes even after his big mistake in the parabolica. The heat in the Renault Twingo Cup now, with Cyril Raymond in the black Twingo. Very important heat for Raymond this one, because his main competitor in the championship, Fabien Grosjean, has retired from the first and second heat, and that means that he can no longer qualify for the finals. So Raymond can make up a lot of ground in this heat, in this event. He's leading the Twingos of Cadedou at the end. Rochard with number 14. And the light blue is the one from Emeric Armage, who's in second position for the moment. The man to follow is Cyril Raymond in the black and orange Twingo with the number 13. Not very superstitious then, Mr. Raymond. Here comes Armage in the baby blue Twingo. Keeps second position even after taking his joker lap. Now leading from Cadedou. And it's Orient Rochard at the end, waiting for the joker lap of Cyril Raymond now. But he has taken this heat. Emphatically, even big lead over the others. It's Cadedou finishing in second, because Armange made a mistake, and Rochard finishes in fourth. Great result for Cyril Rimaud, qualifying then on the front row of the A final. Off to the Super 1600 with championship leader Jean-Baptiste Dubourg in the white Clio with the blue stripes, fighting with David Olivier in the white Twingo, and Laurent Chatrin, reigning champion, in the Citroën C2, taking the exterior line, sliding almost wide, still in there. Now is the inside line, there's contact there, a push between Chatrin and Olivier, but it's Chatrin leading from Olivier, and Jean-Baptiste Dubourg has taken his joker lap. Behind them, it's Nicolas Gouriot in the Citroën DS3. Let's see if Jean-Baptiste Dubourg can take the advantage of that early joker lap. He was in third at the moment. The damage of the contact in the early corners clearly visible at the rear of the Twingo of David Olivier. Laurent Chatrin still leading. Olivier goes for the joker lap. And where is Dubourg? There's Dubourg coming down with the white Clio. Will he get in front of Olivier? Yes! That's one spot gained for the championship leader. Olivier must have lost some time behind Chatrin, and now both of them are looking to pass Nicolas Gouriot in the white Citroën DS3. Here comes Gouriot, then Dubourg and Olivier. Laurent Chatrin still leading this heat. Olivier losing some ground there. Joker lap now for Gouriot. So now it's up to Dubourg and Olivier to reel in Laurent Chatrin. But he has a massive lead. Gouriot drops back to fourth position. Only one man has to take his joker lap. That's Laurent Chatrin, the reigning champion. Very well at ease apparently in these difficult conditions. A bit less so Dubourg and Olivier, because look at the lead that Chatrin has. He had the advantage of being the leader the whole heat, of course, so no dirt or mud on his front window. A clean windscreen for him, and that helps him to take the heat win and set the best time overall in this second heat. Dubourg finishes in second, Olivier in third. But a very happy Chatrin, but first we talk to Olivier.
Conditions très difficiles aujourd'hui. Hier, c'était sec, de bonnes conditions. Et puis aujourd'hui, là, le déluge, ça change toute la donne. Hier, ça s'était très bien passé puisque j'avais gagné la première manche. Et aujourd'hui, je partais en pôle, je suis bien parti. Et puis au deuxième virage, j'ai pris un petit coup derrière, certainement involontaire. Ce qui me fait rater le point de corde, et du coup je perds l'avantage, et après dans la terre, dans la gadoue, j'y voyais pas grand chose, donc je crois que je dois faire le quatrième temps de la manche.
Avant on était cumeaux.
Cette année on roule avec des pneus Avon, et pour dans la pluie il y a des pneus terre, c'est une grande différence?
Non, c'est pas réellement différent, puisque l'année dernière c'était déjà cette configuration là avec une autre marque de pneus. La différence de l'année dernière, c'est que le pneu slick est plus performant. Donc on se pose un petit peu plus la question, c'est-à-dire que le pneu slick pourrait presque nous permettre de rouler sous la pluie dans la mesure où il n'y a pas trop de terre. Bon, ici on ne s'est pas posé la question longtemps parce qu'avec la pluie qui est tombée et l'état de la piste, avec qui est une piste qui a beaucoup de terre, donc on a opté pour les pneus terre, quoi.
And a happy Laurent Chatrin as well.
Laurent, la deuxième manche dans des conditions très délicates, comment c'était avec une traction avant?
Très bien, moi je me suis régalé, j'ai fait une super manche et puis j'étais à l'aise, comme je sais le faire sous la pluie, ça me fait pas froid aux yeux et vraiment sur ce terrain là je me régale à chaque fois que je roule, donc c'est magnifique.
A very happy Chatrin then, feeling well at ease in these difficult conditions. Off to the supercars then with championship leader Jérôme Grosjean in his Clio WRC. Good start for Grosjean, Hervik Knapik well behind already, and Yves Gallet in the Saxo 4x4 as well. Let's take a ride with a championship leader. Even the asphalt looks very slippery. Already a massive lead for Grosjean over Knapik and Gallet. Knapik still aiming for a top three in the championship. This man is going for the title and has a massive lead as well. Lost to Fabien Payet last time round. Still has a big lead over the Peugeot driver, who hasn't competed in every round of the French championship. But here, Rosa Janin is looking good, setting quick lap times and going for the fastest time in this heat, cutting the corners there, going through rain-filled puddles and an emphatic heat win for Rosa Janin. In second, it's Gallet even who beats Hervé Knapik to the flag. So a good result for the leader in the championship, Jérôme Grosjean.
C'est des conditions qui sont vraiment difficiles, changeantes. Donc on essaye de s'adapter au mieux et d'anticiper le setup de la voiture pour être bien sur ces pistes compliquées. Voilà, on découvre un peu aussi les pneus terre parce que c'est la première fois qu'on roule vraiment avec les pneus terre du championnat de France. Donc voilà, c'est plein de découvertes sur une nouvelle piste. Voilà, plein de bonnes choses.
That was the end of part one from Paul Rouen. See you after the break. Welcome back in Paul Rouen for the sixth round of the French Rallycross Championship. The sun is there as well. And we look at the A final in Division 4 with Stephen Lefrancois in the Peugeot 206 on pole, but on the outside it's David Henry in the C4 who takes the best start from Lefrancois and Tommy Tepperot, Jimmy's brother. Jimmy is leading the championship, but his engine of the Audi failed. Massive mayhem there in the first corner. But it's David Henry leading from Lefrancois and Tepperot. Florian Zavatin with his blue Clio went for an early joker lap. And I think Christophe Barbier, his race is already over and done with. Here comes Henry, then Lefrancois, then Tepperot. Toby Tepperot in his first event of the year, doing very well in third there. Lefrancois goes for the joker lap, almost hit Tepperot there. Lost some time there, the Honda driver. And that's to the advantage of David Henry in the Citroën C4. And here's the Citroën Xara of Frédéric Seigneur going wide in that corner. And the Clio of Zavatin still trailing that plastic Armco. Tepperot now going for the joker lap. Can he stay in front of Lefrancois? I don't think he can. No, he rejoins behind Lefrancois and David Henry. Those three have done the joker laps. Top three positions behind them, Sébastien Leferrand in the 306 and Sébastien Guillemot in the 306, but the win is for Stephen Lefrancois in the Peugeot 206 with a massive lead over David Henry, who just takes it from David Henry and Sébastien Leferrand. Sébastien Guillemot is in fifth. Great win then for Stephen Lefrancois.
C'était une course très difficile parce que on a frotté le rail dès les essais chrono, il y a eu beaucoup de réparations, mon équipe a, on peut même pas dire bien travaillé, je crois qu'il n'y a pas de mots pour qualifier ça, ils ont refait une voiture qui est hyper performante et ça je crois que voilà, ça envoie qu'en fait une course c'est pas que le pilote, il faut aussi une équipe et voilà, c'était leur week-end et c'était normal qu'il fallait gagner, il n'y avait pas le choix.
A very emotional Steven Lefrancois thanking his team that has rebuilt his car after an incident in the early time practice. In the championship, it's still Jimmy Tepperot leading from Stephen Lefrancois. The difference is 16 points. Sébastien Guillemot is in third. And it seems to be that Stephen Lefrancois has won the champagne battle as well. Division 3, they're at Marc Maurice on pole. Next to him, Christophe Sonnoy in the Toyota. On the outside, Xavier Briffaut with the Renault Clio. And it's Briffaut who takes the best start from Maurice. And then it's Bourdonneau in the Mini Cooper. Championship leader Sonnoy on the inside there. Can he gain a spot? No, he's hit by Bourdonneau and he goes for the joker lap. Yes, indeed. It's Briffaut leading for Marc Maurice and then Florent Bourdonneau. In the background, championship leader Sonnoy second on the grid. Went for an early joker lap that might give him a good result in the end. For the moment, still the top three that was fixed in the first corner, Briffaut from Maurice and Bourdonneau. I expect Bourdonneau to go for a joker lap. But it's Maurice. Good choice maybe from Marc Maurice.
He could keep Sonnois behind him. Sonnois, who seems to have made a mistake, and that might be very costly in the championship as well, because if Maurice has a good result and Sonnois hasn't, Maurice can take the championship lead. This is Mathieu Trévignon in the Citroën Saxo in third for the moment. Xavier Briffaut going for his joker lap. Can he rejoin in front of Maurice or not? That's the important fact to watch. And it's Maurice who takes that position from Briffaut. That's one spot gained, and with the two cars in front of him still having to go for their joker lap. This is looking good for Marc Maurice in the black Peugeot. But he could lose some time behind the Citroën Saxo of Mathieu Trévignon. He's right behind the white Citroën. Here comes Boudonneau out of his joker lap. He rejoins in between Maurice and Briffaut, so Briffaut loses another place. Boudonneau now in second, is going for another podium finish, but the win is again not for him. The win will go to Marc Maurice. And with Christophe Sonnois only in seventh position, Marc Maurice is now the new championship leader in Division 3. A great result for the Peugeot driver then.
Oh, super finale, ça s'est vraiment bien passé. J'ai pas pris un super départ, bon voilà, mais j'ai préféré laisser faire et puis voir ce qu'il allait devenir petit à petit. Mais je pense que j'étais rapide, c'est pour ça que après mon tour de joker, j'ai pu remonter petit à petit et puis je suis super content d'avoir gagné ici pour la première course à Pont-de-Rouen.
Marc Maurice is very happy to have won this first race here in Pont-de-Rouen. Played the waiting game during a lot of the final, but his speed gave him the win. And gave him the championship lead as well. He now has 4 points in hand over Christophe Sonnois and 23 over Florent Boudonneau. The final in the Twingos then, with Cyril Raymond on pole. Next to him, it's Debain and Liebner on the outside. Enzo Liebner in the red, white and blue. Twingo taking the lead from Cyril Raymond. And in third, it's Julien Debain in front of Julien Anodot. Fernand Kadadou in fifth. Good start from Enzo Liebner. He needs a good result because in the championship he's way behind. This is Pascal Hutto now in sixth position. Refocusing again on the lead now. Liebner from Raymond, and then the fight between the two Juliens. For the moment it's the bear in front of Anodot. Kadedu is in fifth. Cyril Raymond with a good result could take the championship lead because, as I've told you before, Fabien Grosjean will not mark any after having retired in two of the three qualifying heats. So what can Cyril Raymond do? Will he go for the outright win, or will he settle for the points for second place, which would give him the championship lead? Fight between Debain and Anodot. Here's Liebner driving alone because Raymond went for his joker lap in his Renault Twingo. He joins in second position, with Anodot going wide there in that corner. Liebner, massive lead over Raymond, but Liebner still has to take his joker lap. So these might be close together quite quickly. Here comes Liebner out of his joker lap. Where is Cyril Raymond? Cyril Raymond can go for the lead. No! He slips in behind the red, white and blue Twingo of Liebner. Can he have another go? Try and take first position. He might try on the inside here, but decides not to. So the win goes to Enzo Liebner in front of Cyril Raymond, and Julien Anodot takes third position. Debain and Kandedu then from Hutto, Crochard and Tom Donat. Great win for Enzo Liebner.
Félicitations, quelle finale!
Quelle dure finale, ouais, une finale vraiment. Très compliqué, mais on a eu un mauvais temps tout le week-end. Le temps n'a pas été. Il faisait beau, il faisait sec, mouillé. Ça n'a pas été facile pour conduire, donc je suis hyper content et je voudrais remercier mes mécanos. C'est grâce à eux que je suis là aujourd'hui. On a monté la voiture de A à Z et voilà, donc je voudrais les remercier.
Enzo Liebner taking his first win of the year, thanking his mechanics. With them, he built his own car from A to Z. But it's Cyril Raymond in the lead of the championship now. He has 9 points in hand over Julien Anodot and 4 more towards Fabien Grosjean. Finally, the Super 1600 then with Jean-Baptiste Dubourg on pole, taking the pole position from the middle position in his white Clio. On the outside, it's David Olivier, but it's Dubourg taking the lead from David Olivier, and then Adrien Sanier in the pink Citroën Sea-Doo. Great start from Dubourg, already championship leader. And Olivier Sanier, Laurent Chatrin. And in the 21, it's David Deland in the Citroën Saxo. Another win might give Jean-Baptiste Dubourg a great lead in the championship. It is already considerable. Has won most of the rounds this year. Olivier now rejoining after his joker lap. He's behind the Peugeot 206 of Emmanuel Martin. And Laurent Chatrin has taken his joker lap as well. So these two might be good for them if they can pass this pale blue Peugeot 206 quite quickly, because they're losing time behind Martin. This is all to the advantage of Jean-Baptiste Dubourg, of course. And Olivier now sticking behind this Peugeot. Can he find a gap? Yes, he can. He's right beside the Peugeot now. The two cars hitting each other. But Olivier gains a position, has passed Martin. Chatrin is still behind him. But I think he has lost too much time indeed. Dubourg goes for his joker lap and rejoins well in front of David Olivier. Adeline Sanier now briefly in the lead, but she still has to take her joker lap. And it's quite important for her to rejoin in front of David Olivier to take second place in the championship, but she doesn't. She rejoins behind Olivier, so she loses her second place in the championship if everything stays like this, and everything will stay like this because we're in the final lap. Or can David Olivier still fight with Jean-Baptiste Dubourg? They're coming out of the final corner, and it's Dubourg who takes the win. From Dubourg, from Olivier, then Sanier, Chatrin fourth, and David Deland in fifth. A great win again for Jean-Baptiste Dubourg, comforting his lead in the championship.
On a eu un week-end vraiment difficile au niveau météorologique, de la pluie, et puis nous on a bossé, on a fait beaucoup de travail. Je tiens à remercier beaucoup Romain, mon mécano, et toute l'équipe des Landes, parce qu'on n'était pas dans le coup du week-end. Et on a osé des choses, on a pris des risques, ça a payé, et franchement je tiens à les remercier, c'est super.
He worked hard all weekend long, Jean-Baptiste Dubourg, to find the right settings, and that paid off. Another great win for the Renault driver. And in the championship, he now has 31 points in hand over David Olivier and Adeline Sanier, who are both on 104 points. A final of the day then in the supercars division, with Paul Citroën Fabien Payet starting from the middle, and he takes the old shot, but only just, from Jérôme Grosjean, championship leader. Rosé Janet decides against it to try and push Fabien Payet, so he is in second now. Knapik in third, and Marcel Barbet in the black and yellow Renault Megane in fourth. A rare sight in the A finals in the supercars division in France. But it's Payet leading again from Rosé Janet. Can he take another win, Payet? Will Rosé Janet settle for second, or will he try and fight and take another win? Here it comes, Grosjean Janet. He decides to go for the joker lap now. Might be good tactics if he can rejoin with nobody in front of him. And that is the case, because he rejoins right in front of Hervé Knapik. Knapik in third with his 207 WRC. Driving with the experienced Knapik here. And here comes Grosjean Janet. Everything depends now on the joker lap of Fabien Payet. Here comes Payet out of the joker lap, and he rejoins well in front of Grosjean Janet. Normally, this should be his now. Or can Grosjean Janet still menace the black and white Peugeot? I don't think he can if he makes mistakes like this. Going wide there on the dirty stuff. So this is Fabien Payet's second win of the year. And he adds a nice donut to that. But Grosjean Janet still in the lead of the championship.
On a fait tout ce qu'il fallait pour être perfo ce week-end. Et puis, il faut féliciter Fabien et son équipe qui ont fait un super boulot encore. Et puis, nous, on va continuer à travailler pour aller chercher ce qui nous a manqué, ce qui nous a fait défaut ce week-end.
Bon, ça s'est bien passé, on est arrivé côte à côte avec Jérôme, mais bon, on avait la bonne trajectoire qu'il fallait, je pense, pour prendre le premier gauche. Bon, Jérôme a vraiment été sport, il n'a pas forcé, donc ça... Non, ça, c'est le premier virage, c'est bien passé, et puis après, bah, j'ai surveillé Jérôme dans mes rétros, j'ai regardé quand est-ce qu'il prenait le joker, et puis je l'ai pris le tour suivant, donc non, ça s'est bien passé.
Payet, controlling the race, regard, looking especially at Grosjeanin to determine his tactics. In the championship, Grosjeanin still has a massive 54 points lead over Payet though, and Knapik is now in third. That was it from Pont du Rouen. See you next time.